Senator Bailey.
On the resolution, Mr. President, thank you for the opportunity. I could find no more fitting topic to have my first speech on the floor. My favorite Dr. King quote, "Our lives begin to end the day we become silent about those things that matter." Now, Martin Luther King Jr. was widely known as the dreamer, but many of his dreams were realized. That's why I'm able to sit before you today, stand before you today, I should say. That is the reason why my grandfather, who grew up in rural North Carolina, was able to make a great living for the family that he provided for, to come to New York and provide for 8 children, send them to college, and to send a grandson to law school, graduate and pass the bar. Dr. King's dream has been realized through me. Dr. King's dreams will continue to be realized through my 2 daughters, Giada and Karina. And as I look into their eyes every day, as I see what's inside their hearts, I realize that his dream has been realized, but we have so much more to go. The March on Washington was not just the March on Washington. The correct name was the March on Washington for Jobs and Freedom. There were demands made at that march. One of the demands was made was for a national minimum wage. And we finally got the fight for 15 going, but we need more for our working class folks. We need more for the men and women that do so much for us. We need to make sure that Dr. King's realized not only on a day, not just in a month, but that we keep that collective spirit alive day after day, time after time. So one of the other things that really struck me about Dr. King was how young he was at the time of his passing. He was a mere 39 years old. I stand before you today as the youngest member of this great distinguished body at 34 years old, and I wonder, I only have 5 years left to do what that man did. It's a lot of weight on my shoulders, but I can bear that burden. That's the reason why I'm here. And as Senator Sanders alluded to, that's the reason why I assume that all of my colleagues are here, to do what matters. So I ask you today, in accordance with Dr. King, what matters to you? What matters to your constituents? And how are we collectively going to make that happen? I will end with a quote from a hip-hop artist, unconventional, but what? A gentleman by the name of Common, and he said something that, "Waiting for the Lord to rise, I look into my daughter's eyes, and I realize I'm going to learn through her. The Messiah might even return through her, but if I'm to do it, I've got to change the world through her." We have to look at our children in our communities. That is who we're going to change the world through. I'm going to be a leader, and I'm going to change the world through my daughters. You change the world through yours, through your constituents, through the lives of the many families in your communities, in your districts that you all proudly represent. While I am new to this body, I am not new to life on this earth, and I hope that we can all make this a better place. Dr. King will want it that way. Thank you all, and God bless Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.